Okay, so now I've kind of told you about the news of us being engaged. This is something that I've been finding very, very useful. Now, when you go to anywhere, whether it be an open day, whether it be the wedding fairs, you'll get a lot of information, a lot of leaflets, and some people find like a wedding planner is really, really useful. So it might have like your guest list, it might have bits and bobs in it, you know, all sections, people's details, like family members that you don't always speak to, so you don't always have their details, you can keep it all logged in together. But I found that this has been really handy, and it's just one of like your typical ring binder style files, just because if everything's in here in order, so anything with your venue, your florist, your cakes, things like that, it really, really helps. And also you'll get things eventually with like paid deposit wise, so you can keep all your receipts all together, so you know where you're up to, you know how much you've paid, and it's really useful. So yeah, going back to like the venue, we booked our venue 2 years in advance of the wedding, and we just completely fell in love. It was very us. We didn't want to get married in Oldham, like I mentioned before. We wanted to go somewhere that was different for us but also different for our guests. And you don't realise sometimes, the further afield that you might go, you sometimes get more for your money. You sometimes, it's just different. It's about you and your partner on your day. It's not about everybody else. It's what you want out of your day. So we chose here, and the place that we're getting married is called Rossett Hall Hotel. It's between Chester and Wrexham, so it's about an hour away from our house. And I just wanted to kind of tell you a little bit about our wedding, because our wedding is a package. It's something that most venues do offer now. They tend to give you a package because obviously they want people to book with them, so more often than not venues will offer packages now, which helps people with money, but it also helps people that don't really want to kind of ring everywhere, get prices, and you know, that's not the budget. Like, you can get a lot in a package. So our package is like, it says the dream package for 2018 that the venue offers. Now I'll go through what we kind of get. You get the room hire for the civil ceremony, which is basically the main room, and you can also have your wedding outside as well. So closer to the date, me and Nick will probably decide if it's going to be inside or if it's going to be out, just so we know. With the weather, who knows, with the bloody English weather. Master of ceremonies, so basically the registrar fees and everything like that, we've sorted that out. Red carpet arrival, so this is obviously for my guests, a glass of Bucks Fizz, bottled beer or sparkling cocktail following the ceremony. I think you can upgrade that if you wanted to with like a glass of champagne. Chef's selection of canapés, and there's a list of canapés as well on here. Four course wedding breakfast, so once everybody's had canapés and a bit of bubbly and probably photographs, we'll go through and have the wedding breakfast. I didn't know why it was called wedding breakfast until one of the ladies told me that it's because it's the first meal that you have as husband and wife, and that's why they call it a wedding breakfast. Two glasses of house red, white or rosé wine to complement the meal. So basically half a bottle of wine per person to go with the meal. A glass of sparkling wine to toast the bride and groom, or champagne if we wanted to upgrade. Now, I've never heard of this before. I have to say, it was the only kind of venue that I've come across. They do one of the suppliers is one of the cake makers, and they do an assorted 3-tier wedding cake as part of the package. Now, we've been down recently and it's changed to a 4-tier wedding cake as part of the package. Now, what you would get is either like the round wedding cake or the square version, and it would be 4 tiers with the ribbon of your choice, whatever kind of theme you've gone for on your wedding, with fresh flowers. Now, we're probably going to put more money to the cake because we want a few bits and bobs, nothing too fancy, but just a little bit more. But you literally get your cake for free, which is perfect, especially if you're on a major, major budget. And I'll show you some leaflets after about all these kind of people. The white chair covers and coloured sashes of your choice. Now, some venues, they might have a package, but this isn't included. But the white chair covers that go on your seats, and the ribbons or bows, whatever you have on your chairs, they're all within the package, which is a really, really, you know, it's so useful. Fresh flowers for the top table arrangement and guest table centerpieces. So for the ceremony room and where obviously you sign the registrar, they have a flower display for that table, and that can be taken through into the wedding breakfast. So it could go on the top table, for example. And then you also get the table centrepieces. Now, there was 3 kind of table centrepieces that you could go for. There was like the bowl version with water and fresh flowers. There was kind of like a flute style with flowers. And there was like these branch tree things with fresh flowers. But we are probably going to, again, put money to. I love flowers, and I think flowers make a wedding. I think they make a room, I think they make a statement, and I do love flowers. I think flowers look gorgeous on photographs. So we're gonna put more money to it, and I've got a Pinterest board, which I'm like, you know, love it. So I love flowers. You also get a printed table plan, place cards and menus. So basically the table plan, they have like a mirror with the table plans on. The place cards for where you're going to be sat. Again, we're probably going to do our own, only because I would like them to kind of tie in with invitations. You get the DJ until 12:30 a.m., which I think is fantastic. I don't have to source my own DJ. We've spoken to him, which was perfect because we just wanted to kind of get a general idea of the music that he plays. So yeah, we'll probably speak to him again really just before the wedding, like 3-4 weeks before the wedding. He said to us, that's fine. You get your evening finger buffet or roast bat buffet. We're gonna have probably a lot of, well, not a lot of day guests, but generally like, it's not gonna be like half and half. It's probably gonna be like 70-30 kind of thing with wedding day guests. And then we also get the bridal suite for the evening of our wedding. So yeah, it's just lovely, and I'm so like happy that we came across this venue. So yeah, the venue is called Rosset Hall Hotel, if you didn't quite catch it before. Anything that I am talking about, I am going to put in underneath my video, so you can click on it if you would like. So that is that one. So that's that. Now I'll show you probably one thing. I'll show you this first. We did a save the date. I haven't used a specific person. I actually created these through my head's gone to mush. What's it called? It's online. I'll post it. It's where you can go on and it gives you a template. We've used those. So this is our save the date. So I didn't really know what the theme was going to be, so I went for something really quite simple because we've still not really chosen a colour theme at that point. So you've got like your tree branches, little lanterns, the N and J in the love heart, which I thought was super sweet. Save the date, our names, the date of the wedding, and then on the back it just says formal invitation to follow. So that was sent out with a little envelope and a sticker which was similar to the heart. So they were sent out just so everybody had like an official card of the date so they could save it. It'll come back to me. What is that thing called? So that was that. Now I'll show you this first. This is the cake lady. She's called Cakes by Andrea Lee. Cheshire. So that is the details for her, and again she's based North Wales in between Chester and Wrexham, so it's perfect for our venue, and just a lot of details on there. I've just got this for her contact details basically. But yeah, if you go on Facebook, I know she's definitely on Facebook because I follow her, so that would be perfect for that. And this is the florist. Now, this is called Vivid Floral Design, and again, based in Wrexham. And just some designs. They do regular posts online as well, on Facebook. And I know that, and where are they? Are they on? No, they're not on Instagram. I thought they might have been on Instagram, but they're not. So yeah, I've followed their page. They do regular posts. So even if it's not the colour that I fancy, I'm still saving it for the details of the style, the arrangement, or anything like that. So we've reserved the date with them as well for, I'm going to have my bouquet, the bridesmaid flowers done there, and I'm also going to get the buttonholes and any kind of more flowers that I might think might work well within the venue, I'm going to have with this particular company. I just thought it would be perfect. It all come from the same place. I've seen the work that they do. It's lovely. So I'm going with it. Now this is where I got my wedding dress from. The store was recommended by my friend who I'm a bridesmaid for at the end of the year. It's called Ava Rose Hamilton, and the original shop was based in Barrowford, which is kind of Bury Burnley way. There's two stores. They have one in Leeds and they have one in Lancashire, but they've just had a brand new opening, which is in Colne. Now it's not too far away from the original shop, but it looks gorgeous, and it's where I will go for like my next fitting. And again, they're all on Facebook. So yeah, that's the name, Ava Rose Hamilton. And just gives you a bit of an idea. They're based in Lancashire and Yorkshire, Leeds. This is just what I received when we used a deposit on, we paid our deposit on my wedding dress. The designers that they sell, oh, I might not be able to tell you all the designers because they've got unusual names. Caroline Castigliano, Ian Stewart, Cobus DiPanar, Anna Sulwai, Lynn Ashworth, La Sposa, Angelina Fasenda, Essence of Australia, which is my dress, Modeka and Anushka G. And they've won awards. They got the Best Bridal Retailer 2013 finalist. They got the winner for the Best Bridal Retailer in 2010. So yes, hello, you peeking through?
Hello.
I'm doing a video. What? Oh, why have you done that? What are you doing? Okay, I'll be 2 minutes. So yeah, they're open kind of during the weeks, but yeah, they were just perfect. They were lovely, lovely girls that helped me out. I went midweek with my mum and my grandma. I probably tried on about 10 dresses, wanted to go for something completely different for me, and ended up going away with something that I really didn't think I would do. So yeah, we did that in September last year. I don't know about anybody else. Some people love the idea of going around to stores, trying on a million dresses, having that whole kind of bridal experience. I did enjoy it. I loved trying the dresses on. I loved being special. But I did find that I can't really explain it, because I've always danced. I've like always done ballroom and Latin dancing. I've kind of got into the, I just couldn't do with the faff. And everyone will be like, what is your wedding dress? And I can't believe you're talking like that. But I don't know. It was just what I wanted to, I just decided on a dress and I loved it. And it's a wedding dress and it's my wedding dress. And I can't wait to go back and try it on. I'm in the middle of losing weight because I go back on 24th of February for kind of a refitment. So come then, I will see it again. I'll probably try like the sample on, which was the size that I'm trying to get down to. So yeah, it's called Ava Rose Hamilton and it's just gorgeous. So those are the kind of things that I've booked up to now. I have got some other bits and bobs, but I need to dig them all out to show everybody. One thing that I have found useful is this. It's only £2.99. It comes out, I don't know if it's every month. Does it come out every month? If you can hear them, they're all having the tea downstairs. It's called Wedding Ideas Magazine and it comes a nice little kind of pocket size, so it's perfect to put in your handbag if you've not quite finished reading or whatever. But yeah, this is it. Now, the one reason why I like it is because it has loads of real life weddings in it. So, for example, it shows you like the couple, it shows you the wedding cake, the hairstyle, the dress, it tells you about their day, it tells you what music they had playing, it tells you what bridesmaid dresses that the bridesmaids wore, what they had playing for their first dance, the venue obviously, the flowers, the cake, the entertainment. So I found that really useful just to give me some ideas of what, I don't know, what we could use possibly. So I bought quite a few magazines of this. When I've got 5 minutes with a cup of tea, I sit down and have a little read and just get all excited. Me and Nick are kind of in that stage at the moment where we don't want to think about it too much because we're not actually getting married until next year and the big things have pretty much been booked. I know Nick is going to be getting his suits June, July time. The couple of places that we've been to have recommended that they go back in the time around the same, around the same time of year that you're going to be getting married. So he's going to go back summer time this year and generally sit down and have a look with his dad and maybe probably take some of his ushers. I haven't told you about who that the bridesmaids and the ushers are going to be, but I'm having Nick's sister as my bridesmaid, my very close friend Nikki, one of my best friends, one of my best friends Amy, and my maid of honour, who's going to be my very, very long time close friend, which is a girl called Becky. I've known her for years. We've grown up together since we were little girls. And there is a video on my YouTube page of me kind of like announcing to them that they were going to be bridesmaids. So there's that one. And then there's also Nick's ushers. So my brother's going to be an usher. Two of Nick's friends, Chris and Michael, and then there's also going to be his best man, who is a very close family, really, really loyal friend, Martin. So they're all going to be part of our wedding. I've got like my two nephews and my niece. So my two nephews are going to be page boys. And my niece Olivia is going to be a bridesmaid because she's going to be 9. I mentioned that before. I was thinking of a flower girl, but she's going to be older. And obviously, our little girl Freya. She's going to be 3 and a half when we get married, so she's a perfect age to be a flower girl. And that is everything really. I've taken up too much time as it is, and I just wanted to let you all know that that's what we're doing, and I'm super, super excited. Any videos along the way, I will show, anything that we buy, anything that we decide on, I'm going to show you all, just to give you some ideas.